was an integral part of Pittsburgh's steel curtain, number 68, L.C. Greenwood. Just look at him here in this Santa's hat. At the 40th anniversary of the Immaculate Reception, Greenwood died last week from kidney failure following back surgery.
And today it was all about remembering his life and his legacy. Here's Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram.
During the service, a minister said L.C. Greenwood gave instructions that his service should not be called a funeral. So it is called a homegoing, filled with joyous music and a lot of fond memories that brought laughter. L.C. Greenwood once told his teammates that L.C. stands for Love Cool. His teammates say Greenwood was wise, regal, spiritual, and funny. They also called him Hollywood Bags, always dressed stylishly. But more than anything, he was called a man of substance.
I tell you what, he's going to be missed. This is a tough one because I don't think nobody was prepared for this.
He had a kind heart, and he was a giver. And another part of that is just the laughter, or the humor.
Greenwood and his family insisted that there should be no weeping at his service, and his sister Annie stated, he's absent from the body, but present with the Lord. But his longtime teammate and friend Joe Green could not hold back the tears. This is what happened as he spoke during the service. Green started to cry and said in a broken voice, I'm going to be sad because I can't pick up the phone. Green could not finish and walked off the stage.
No doubt about it, L.C. was loved by a lot of people, and, you know, I've been a friend of his since 1969.
He was real. He was real. He loved the Lord, and that's what comforts me, is that I know that he's in a better place, and I know that he's with the Lord.
And so now L.C. Greenwood leaves Pittsburgh for the last time to follow up on his lifelong request to be buried with his mother and father in his hometown in Mississippi. Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.